Welcome to North of the Broad. I'm your host, Robin Zimmerman. We bring you our show each month from the Pat Conroy Literary Center. So stay tuned. We've got a great lineup of guests for you. Welcome to North of the Broad. I'm your host, Robin Zimmerman. Our first guest, as always, is Jonathan Haupt. He is executive director for this fabulous Pat Conroy Literary Center. So, Jonathan, good to see you. It's been a great year. Happy holidays to you.
Happy holidays, Robin. Absolutely.
So we're going to look forward into 2021. You know, my new mantra is fun in 21.
I like that.
You like that?
Yes, that's going to catch on, I think.
That's going to catch on. Pretty simple, but we need to celebrate the vaccine and hopefully a better year. But you've had a good year here at the Pat Conroy Literary Center, and I want to look forward now to the, in particular, an event that you've had before, the March 4th, but it's going to be a little different this year. So share with us how it's going to be different from last year.
That's right. Well, as you say, we've had a really surprisingly good year here at the Conroy Center by discovering a virtual audience and the way to do those programs in a really meaningful way. So that'll be the case for the very first time with what is otherwise our fifth annual March 4th. This is an annual program that we created to commemorate the day that Pat Conroy passed away, March 4th of 2016, with a day not of mourning, but of learning and celebration about topics that were really central to Pat's life. And this has always been a one-day event, and I invited people with that model in mind, but there were so many people who are interested, it's now grown into a three-day virtual event for the first time ever.
So let's kind of dive down into the 3 days. What, to kind of give us an overview, what will happen, Jonathan?
Sure, absolutely. We're excited to have a couple of New York Times bestselling writers participating this year.
Who are they?
And again, because it's virtual, you can come from anywhere.
Right, sort of which
open,
is great.
The doors open wider.
That's
yes. So there's a fantastic writer originally from Savannah named Bruce Feiler, who did Council of Dads and Walking the Bible and all these wonderful things, several of which have been turned into TV shows.
I thought Council of Dads had, yeah.
He was, yeah, right. Filmed in Savannah, too.
Right. Okay.
And Bruce has a Conroy connection that he hasn't had much chance to talk about. So on March 4th, on Thursday, March 4th, we'll be presenting him virtually as an entirely free event, open to anybody, anywhere, live streamed on our Facebook page.
Good.
His new book is called Life is in the Transitions, and it's sort of appropriate for the idea of marching forth as well.
Right.
And he'll be in conversation with Reverend Patrick Perryman from First Presbyterian Church here in Beaufort, who we know at the Conroy Center as Holland Perryman's dad, but he does have a life beyond that as well.
Okay, great.
And this will be a nice conversation for them to have as the opening event.
Okay, that'll be on Thursday.
Yes.
All right.
Then all day Saturday, the 6th, and into Sunday afternoon, the 7th, we have seven more programs.
Wow.
There is a modest registration fee for that, $25, but it gives you access to anything. You can pop in and out as much as you want.
Anything special those 2 days you want to highlight?
Oh, absolutely, yes. Our other New York Times bestselling writer is joining us midday Saturday. This is Bakari Sellers, who was South Carolina's youngest state representative, more recently a commentator on CNN, and he's the author of a fantastic memoir called My Vanishing Country. Bakari's father, Cleveland Sellers, who was an icon of the civil rights movement, was our guest at March 4th 2 years ago.
Okay.
So this is a nice way to link up those events as well.
Well, is that his first book, or is that...
It is his first book.
Okay.
Fantastic book as well, and has done incredibly well. So we're really grateful that he was able to make some time for us on March 4th.
All right, fantastic. So anything else you want to highlight about that particular event for 2021?
Sure. I'll mention just very quickly an author we have who is really the central point of Sunday. This is Drew Lanham, who has been a part of four of our five March 4ths, who's sort of our returning champion, as we say. And Drew would ordinarily lead the Nature Walk, which isn't going to be possible with a virtual event. So he's going to appear with his own mentor, John Lane, and they're going to have a really conversation about what that student-teacher relationship has meant to them over the years.
Okay, fantastic. And our last 30 seconds or so, the center will have a little brief reprieve for some relaxation and rejuvenation, and then you'll open back up on the weekend, the first weekend in January. Is
that right? That's right, yes. So ordinarily Thursday through Sunday, noon to 4 p.m. Right here in downtown Beaufort.
And so, of course, with COVID hopefully subsiding over the next 6 months, will you continue the virtual and then begin to maybe have some in-person events in 21?
I think so. We're moving forward in both directions because we've found audiences in both directions, and we want to keep both of them. It's been wonderful to engage
that been fantastic?
People everywhere.
Wow. And you've had a year of celebration and learning, too. I mean, just think, you know, COVID, it's a downer, but it's been an opener in many ways.
It has been for us. We've been making it up as we go along, which is what we do every day here at the Conroy Center anyway. So we've made the best of it.
Well, thank you so much, Jonathan, and happy again. Happy holidays, and let's have a great fun in 21.
I like that. Yes. Thank you, Robin.
And we'll be right back. Stay tuned.